ऑल्सो देर आर गोइंग टू बी क्वाड्रेटिक्स हियर. लेट्स लुक एट प्रॉब्लम 11. सो एक्स स्क्वायर मॉड ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 9 इक्वल्स टू मॉड ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 5. ओके सो मॉड ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 9 इक्वल्स टू मॉड ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 5. नाउ एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 9, वॉट इज द कर्व एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 9 लुक लाइक. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम गोइंग टू लुक एट द कर्व एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 9. सो मॉड ऑफ सो एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 9 इट विल बेसिकली लुक लाइक दिस. माइनस 3 एंड 3 आर द टू रूट्स ऑफ दिस प्रॉब्लम. सो दिस इज द कर्व ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 9. नाउ लेट्स से आई एम इंटरेस्टेड इन मॉड ऑफ एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस 9. So what mod function does is whenever it is positive it will be as it is, whenever it is negative it will report the negative of it, and then like this. So this is what the mod function looks like. So this is the function for mod of x square minus 9. Okay, similarly mod of x square minus 5, it will take its zero values at root 5 plus minus root 5. So it will look like this, this, this and this. Okay, so this is what it will look like. This will be minus root 5 and this will be plus root 5. Okay, so I hope you all know how to draw quadratic graphs. Quadratic graphs we have done a lot in schools. So what we do is we just, so a positive quadratic always looks upward like a u function. This is always, so if you have any quadratic ax square plus bx plus c with a positive, then it always looks like this, and the, if the roots are r1 and r2, then these are going to be the points r1 and r2. Okay, if it is negative quadratic, then it looks like this. These are going to be the roots r1 and r2. So since you have both positive quadratics, they'll both look like upward u. Now whenever they become negative, the mod function will convert the negative into positive. Now, as you can see, the intersection points of these two graphs are these two things. Okay, so either you can just apply symmetry and find one of these points and just report if this point is x, this answer has to be minus x. So that's one way to do it. So I'm going to go ahead with this methodology. So I know that this curve is, so if you look at the blue curve in this region, this curve is x square minus 5. In this region it is 5 minus x square, and in this region it is again x square minus 5. When you talk about the red curve, in this region it is x square minus 9, in this region it is x square minus 9, but in the middle section it is 9 minus x square. So whenever x is less than 3, mod x is less than 3, your x square is going to be less than 9, so the internal value is going to be negative. So you have to reverse it when you remove the modulus function. So mod of x square minus 9 will become 9 minus x square, okay, for the internal values. So at a point like this, the x square minus 5 is behaving as x square minus 5, and mod of x square minus 9 is behaving as 9 minus x square. So the solution is going to be 9 minus x square is equals to x square minus 5. So that's our solution. So that's how we are going to do it. 9 minus x square equals to x square minus 5, which implies 2x square is equals to 14, which implies x square equals to 7, which implies x equals to plus minus root 7. So since we are only operating on the positive part, we have assumed this to be on the positive part, we are going to discard the negative value first of all, and then we are going to say that this point is x equals to, sorry, then we are going to say that this point is x equals to root 7, and by symmetry this point minus x is root 7, and by symmetry the other point is x equals to minus root 7. So the solutions that we are looking for is x equals to plus minus root 7. Okay, so you will have to do a little bit of quadratic equations. A lot of quadratics here, they do not have obvious roots. For example, like this one or this one. So if you go till question number 16, you can still do this, but you will need the roots. So what I suggest is just go online, okay, and you'll get equation solvers. So you'll get quadratic equation solver and cubic equation solver. So you can just Google it up. So you can Google cubic equation calculator. You can go for any of the links that you get. So this is x cube plus x square plus 4x plus 4. So you can just write this as, so this equation is, you can equate it to ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d. So the abcd are 1144. So you can just substitute these values here and calculate. Okay, so you'll get your answers. So there is only one real solution, minus 1. Okay, so this cubic has just one real solution, minus 1. So I do not want you to get into solving cubics and quadratics. Those are not required at all. But if at all you are interested, you can make use of these calculators. Don't fret over it. Otherwise, you can just stick till question number 15. That is like sufficient, more than enough from this part, at least modulus part. So you do not need to go beyond question number 15. As far as this exam is concerned, if you want to do something extra on your own, then you can proceed, but don't try to get tied up with finding roots of quadratic and roots of cubic equations. Yeah.